The cart button. There's a lot to cover about this, but we'll do it quickly and efficiently, maybe even cutting into some of the rambling anatomy of the cart button, customizing default elements, adding and removing elements, the cart quantity element, and, if we have time, showing the subtotal inside our cart button. Let's take a look at the anatomy of the cart button. If we dig inside, in our navigator here, we can see it has a few things. It has an icon, it has some text, in ours it says cart, and it has a cart quantity element. That's the current number of items in a customer's cart. Let's talk about the icon, specifically the icon color. Want to change it? Make sure the icon's selected. You know how we change text or font color for our typography? Look, same thing here. That's icon color. Cart text. A while back, we saw a text block, and in the script for this very video, we mentioned that in ours, it says cart. But we can do more here. We can edit the text, of course, but we can also get text from our actual cart. Check this out. We can grab the text that reflects our current quantity, or subtotal. Gives us a lot of flexibility in the event we don't want it to say cart, as it did earlier in this very video. What about cart quantity? This text block is already connected to the cart quantity field, and you can style this just like you can style any text element. Now, let's look at adding or even removing content from our cart button. You can add stuff to the button, just add stuff to the button. You can delete stuff from a button, just delete. About the only thing you can't delete is the cart quantity element, but you can hide it. Let's dig into that. Cart quantity. We can double-click the element called cart button. That's our cart button. From here, we can hide the cart quantity by toggling the switch. We can turn it back on, then off again, and back on. And in the cart quantity element itself, we can go over there in the navigator, just selecting our cart quantity element. And we can use this under element settings to hide the cart quantity if the cart is empty. That means there won't be the number zero if someone hasn't added something to their cart. Finally, we can show the subtotal separately in a cart button. If you want to show the subtotal, you can add a text block to your cart button. And like we demonstrated before, from our settings, we can get the text from the cart subtotal. So, that's a lot we covered. To quote Dickinson, saying nothing sometimes says the most. So, we'll just mute for the rest.